Tenuous at best was all he had to say when pressed about the rest of it, the world that is. From Proto-Sanskrit Minoans to Portocentric Lisboans, Greek Cypriots and Habesats who hang around in ports a lot,
I'm exploring. There's no answer. There's no answer.
Here's the thing, start getting weird watching this man with scratch the bits of home.
It's like the mystery is happening, and I'm part of it. That's what's so great about it. I mean, it's just like, holy shit, what am I going to do next? And every time there's something that you didn't do before because you can't. It's like the adventure of life. If you throw yourself into it, you get something out. Sometimes good and sometimes not so good, but you get something. My life has been driven and challenging and exciting and complicated and all the other things that everybody's life is. Have I had difficulties and have I had lots of adversity? Absolutely. But it's within me that I absolutely have to make things. I just have to. Pretty well everything in this house is something that I have designed or made. If I want it, I just make it. I figure out how to do it so that it has a design that I'm happy with and it's finished the way I like and it's what I want. I have a kind of sense of peace, which might have to do with my age and coming to terms with myself and accepting what I am. And it's just within my soul, I have to have simplicity. I have no worries about whether I mean anything or I have a strength. I am me and I'm just doing it now and I'm right there. That's it. There's nothing more.
Who wants to look upon this?
The absolute number one best piece of advice I think I ever got and that I in turn can pass on is the best thing you can do to have a career in music is just to play 400 or 500 gigs and you'd be amazed what will happen in between that time. I spent about 4 years writing this last record on the road, on trains in Europe and Australia and all across the US. I found that I accidentally wrote a backhanded love letter to Vancouver. I often steal things from conversations that I've had, or like, you know, I read a street sign or something that triggers an idea, and I assume that if I'm feeling a certain way because of something, that probably out there other people are feeling the same way. I think that emotion and experience is really universal. Send it home for just one stop at the good life. That's enough and I'm so. Everything around us is the result of somebody making choices. I feel like that's really what art is about. It's just making really purposeful choices. So I gave up all my wretched thoughts.
Imaginary futures are much more realistic if they're constructed, for the most part, out of the neglected stuff from the past. My idea of creativity and the unconscious sounds like what some people would call channeling. It's only intermittently a pleasant process for me. Ordinarily, it's just a sort of like grinding anxiety of apparent procrastination. I'm not the guy who actually writes the book. And no one really gets to meet the guy who actually writes the book. And the thing that I dislike most about him is how intermittently he's willing to turn up. So I'm the guy who has to get up every morning, sit in the chair in front of the computer, and be prepared to take dictation from the guy who writes the book. And I think that's the muse that we've always been told about in the arts. It's some part of ourselves that we really don't have access to, and which actually does seem to me, when I'm having that experience, to be something greater than myself.
There's a lot more to being a dancer than I think most people initially think.
To be part of a profession in which sharing and showing your vulnerability is, I believe, a really beautiful thing.
We're really fortunate as artists, and especially as dancers, because we really have to come into the studio every day and look at ourselves and work on ourselves.
When you're on stage, you're not just putting on a face, you're not just putting on a character, right? You have to dig something from yourself and give it, you know? And you have to be totally, totally honest.
Your body doesn't lie, and whatever you're experiencing inside is gonna come out.
It's like doing emotion. You know, it's very easy to do this, but what is that without any kind of intention? To me, intention brings that other element that an audience can feel.
Sometimes you, in performance, you get graced with the magic, and that's, I think, when the audience comes away moved, is when we can somehow be invested enough in each moment and pure enough that we can let ourselves get out of the way and let the exchange happen.
I'm Ian Tracy. I'm an actor. When approaching a role, you have a script that's telling you what to think. So first of all, I like to just sit and really digest the script. And I know if it's a good script, if I can visualize in my head as I'm reading, if I can see the movie already. A lot of times what I do when I first get a project is to really analyze the character from as many directions as I can. Maybe how the character thinks, how they move, where they're from. You like to give your character a backstory.
We'll be right back.
You're a servant of entertainment. It's like if the production was the restaurant, and the producer is the owner, and the director is the manager, the actors are the waiters. They're being given a character by the kitchen, like a meal to take to the people. It's providing a service to the people.
My name is Parviz Tanavoli. I was born in Tehran, Iran. I'm a sculptor. I mean, this country is so beautiful, and I get all kind of inspiration. I look at the landscape here, I look at the birds, I look at the trees. It has an impact on me. To me, this is a very beautiful procedure that you look at something else and your own ideas get better developed. They get more poetic, or they get finer. it is not that my art is based on any religion or Muslim or Shiite religion, but they are the concepts of mysticism in my art. This, of course, is derived from the Persian poetry. Although the poetry is very divine, but also is very human. I have brought another culture here, and I am trying to introduce this culture to the people of British Columbia.
I'm Fred Herzog. I'm a photographic artist. My photographs are me. They are not an intellectual product. What triggers my response to a scene is something that I am. My experience, my history, my psychology. I'm an intense person. I can't do things casually. I can't stand around at parties and make lighthearted conversation. I said, I can't do that. And in the same way, I'm a photographer. I can't just dabble in photography or take snaps. My pictures are focused with full intensity. I noticed very early when I took pictures, even in the 1950s, as this culture is not dissimilar to the culture we had in Germany, but the culture is sufficiently different to make me astonished of how different it was. To me, Vancouver looked exotic. I had the advantage of seeing it from a different perspective. And that's the gift of extraordinary photography, that you see something which other people do not see.
My name is Rosario Anse.
I'm Victor Colsti.
And we are Flamenco Rosario. When I dance flamenco, I get lost in myself. I'm not myself anymore, but I'm part of the music and part of the singing and part of something bigger.
Well, when it's all working together, it's like you get into a zone and everybody's connecting, the singer, everybody that's doing the hand clapping and the footwork.
That is very powerful. It is that feeling that you say, yes, everything fits so perfectly that you lose yourself in the music and the moment. It's a moment that is there and then it's done. When people see flamenco, they feel, yeah, I need that. They always say that, I needed that in my life.
My name is James Chang. I'm an architect. We cannot separate humans from nature. So my challenge has always been, how do you bring back nature or fragments of nature in a super high density environment? I think our human spirit needs that. My design philosophy is life between buildings. For me, it's more important to deal with the spaces between buildings than the iconic building itself. It should be an additive process.
So whatever building we design should add to the city, add to the community, rather than subtract from it. I think that's probably the only part that's consistent throughout my design career. I think those are intrinsic values that I held very high, and I think they're the sort of my check marks for every project that we do. Intuitively, people know what they want and what they enjoy. As architects or designers, we just have to make sure we can create them for them.
My name is Kathy Falk. I'm an artist. I like to make things that have never been made before. I like to use whatever comes to my mind that is a great idea. I give people a new way of looking at various things. It's not a matter of looking at it differently so much as looking at it. Really looking, seeing what is in front of them, rather than just using the, using the table and so on. What isn't everyday stuff? Photographs of hills, is that everyday stuff? Yeah, of course it is. By the way, I painted the ocean. I painted the night skies quite a few times. Is that ordinary or is that extraordinary? A piece of the ocean, is that ordinary? It's like enlarging the language of observation.
Hi, my name's Sean Hunt, and I'm a Herzog artist. My work reflects my two different backgrounds. I'm Herzog from British Columbia, and then also I have Scottish ancestry. Together, when I pull from both of those, I get kind of a different hybrid style of art. I find that native art can sometimes be, or people's impression of it is that it's this stoic and very old and ancient. You know, I'm always looking for new ways to take that traditional art form and bring it up to the present. I think it's a great way to tell stories. The artist is at the forefront of my culture and somebody that is a recorder of what happens, but also somebody that can help influence the things to happen. I see my work as more of a catalyst for a conversation than necessarily an answer. For the most part, it's an obsession. My artwork is an obsession.
Live and to sing and feel that sense of connectedness to other human beings is really powerful. I've been down a long road. I think if you want to be an artist, you have to ask yourself some hard questions. I mean, you have to really, really want it. It has to be something that you need to do. It has to be because it feeds you. Nothing came from wanting. There's a great freedom in not insisting on going from A to B to C to D and sort of going through this long process of quite often getting back to the very first thing you tried, which is what we all would often do in the studio. This time it was like, nope, I gave a really rough chart to the musicians and we pressed record. Here's the song, go. And, you know, everybody was, you know, on the front lines. They went, well, I have to perform here. There was real freedom in that. people don't connect as human beings that much anymore. And so I think the role of an artist in our society is incredibly important because we are communicators. We leave a positive mark on the consciousness of everybody who came. And when I talk to individuals and they come up to me and they say, you know, a particular song will really move them, I mean, that's the greatest validation an artist can have. I touch someone's life that I don't even know. It's powerful.
I've been down a long road. I became a stranger to myself. Digging in my heels and hoping time might be kinder if I waited out. But nothing came from wanting, and I became so small and insecure. I didn't know the cost of all I'd lost till I found it fresh and new again. Bright, electrified.